Hi team, welcome to Automation for Testers. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about accessor methods like concat, includes, index of and last index of. Okay. So if you are not sure what is meant by accessor methods, you can check out my earlier videos on arrays. So we have three different ways of methods like mutator methods, accessor methods and iterator methods. Okay, so as a part of this lecture, we are going to discuss about four accessor methods. Okay, so in that, the first one is what? Concat method. Okay, so here we have one method. What is that one, guys? Concat. Okay, there you can see combines two or more arrays. Okay, that means, for example, if I say 100, okay, so log and try to use this method, and after that, I will just try to run the program. Okay, there you can see 100 has been added. Okay, so like this, you can add one element or else you can add more than one element also. For example, if I say 300, try to rerun your program, there you can see it got added in the last. Okay, so like that, concat method adds what? New elements in the end. There you can see combined two or more arrays. That means you can add any number of arrays by using the concat method. Okay, so this you can see this one we can say spread operator. Okay, that means you can pass any number of parameters to it. Okay, so now I hope this method is very easy, just concatenating the values to the end of the array. Okay, so this is not going to affect the original arrays, guys. So as we discussed in the earlier topics. Okay, so now let's talk about the different method. What is the different method we have, guys? Apart from this one, we are discussing about something called what? Includes. Okay, so now let's talk about the includes method. Error dot includes. Okay, so now put the cursor over here. Determines whether an array includes a certain element or not. So true, returning true or false is appropriate. For example, my requirement is I want to check whether the element 31 is there or not in the this particular array. So what I can do, I can pass this 31. Okay, so log and try to run the program. Okay, there you can see true. That means there is a value 31 in the array. For example, if I mark it as 30, if I change the value and try to run the program, there you can see false, because this array does not include any value with the 31. So because of that reason, it has given you what? False value. Okay, so like this, if you want to verify given element present in the array or not, you can use the includes method. Okay, so remember, it is applicable for only the first occurrence. If it finds the first occurrence, it will stop searching and it will give you the true value. Okay, I hope this one is very easy and very clear for you. Now let's go to the third method. Which one, guys? Index of. Okay, so arr dot index of. Okay, so there you can see returns the index of the first occurrence of a value in the array. What this one will give, this one will do for you? Includes method will check whether the element is present or not, true or false. But if you want to know that index, okay, you can go ahead with which method, guys? Index of method. For example, I want to know what is the value, what is the index of the 30. Okay, so CLS, try to run the program, there you can see 3. So 0, 1, 2, 3. Index it is giving you, right? So what is the value that you are passing, it will give you what? Index of it. For example, if the element is not present, okay, there you can see it is giving you -1. That means it is not present in the array itself. Okay, so like this, by using the index method, it will give you what? The first occurrence index value for you. Okay, for example, if more than one element is there, for example 30 and 30, so try to search for it. Okay, there you can see it is giving you 3 only. So what does this mean? First occurrence of the element and its index it is going to return to you. Okay, so now we have one more method. Which one is, guys? Last index of. Same method. Okay, only thing that we need to do is what? Just add last index of. Try to run the program and see, it is giving you 7. So what does this mean? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That means from the last it will start looking in. For example, there you can see returns the index of the last occurrence of a specified value. So which is the last occurrence, not the first one. Whereas this one will look for what? First occurrence, and this one will look for what? The last occurrence. There may be more than elements also. For example, 300 is there. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter for us. So from here only it will search. From here only it will count. But which is the last occurrence? Which is the last occurrence? Okay. So like this, both index of and last index of will give you what? First occurrence and last occurrence of a element whose it will give you index, guys, not the values. You need to pass the values and it will give you what? Indexes. Okay. So include methods. Yes, if you want to know whether the given array contains some elements or that particular element or not, you can check that using the include methods. And concat method is to what? Add the specified set of values, one value or more than one value, to the end of the array using the concat method. Okay. I hope you are able to understand these four methods, guys. That's all for this session, guys. Thanks for joining the session.